matters this morning. Duke Energy's rate hike in North Carolina, it may be delayed, and Samsung is getting ready to unveil its answer to the iPhone 10. Jane King live at the NASDAQ to explain Samsung taking on Apple.
Oh, yes. They're going to have a big reveal this weekend, so we'll have more on that in a second. But Duke Energy Carolinas wants regulators to delay a hearing on its proposed 13% rate hike until March 5th. So they're hoping they'll have ruled by then on a separate Duke Energy Progress rate case. So it wants to wait on that ruling involving Progress that may determine if customers will pay for the cost of upgrading Duke's coal ash operations to meet stricter regulations. Now, that's supposed to happen March 1st, according to Biz Journals. And Toyota dominated the competition in Consumer Reports 2018 ranking of the best vehicles in the U.S. The winners were the Corolla for compact car, Camry for midsize, Highlander for midsize SUV, and the Sienna for minivan. Consumer Reports says Toyota is dependable, has mainstream design and safety. Well, a new analysis says guys often lie about the cost of an engagement ring. The New York Post talked to the head of Legendary. That's a website that connects diamond sellers with potential buyers and encourages underbidding. He says men will often let their significant other be blissfully unaware if they got a deal on the ring. And Samsung will unveil the Galaxy S9 this weekend. The tagline for the launch is Camera Reimagined. The Galaxy S series is Samsung's most important product line. Last year, about one in every five smartphones shipped across the world came from Samsung, according to IDC. And Apple may be gearing up to update its wireless AirPod earbuds, according to a report. The first of two updates expected to land later this year. It will feature built-in Siri functionality. That's according to Bloomberg. The report also says the second update is a water-resistant model that will be able to withstand splashes, rain, and sweaty workouts. And the speediest drive-through service can be found at Wendy's, Dunkin' Donuts, and Raising Cane's. QSR Magazine, out with its annual drive-through performance study, Carl's Jr. and Hardee's lagged behind the competition with the two slowest times in Starbucks, also slower than most other restaurants. The tech companies did lead stocks mostly higher yesterday, but financial firms fell. The Dow did close up 165 points, and we're looking higher this morning. Live from the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Jane King from Fox 8 News. Back to you.
The guys lying about the engagement rings, don't they realize at some point the wife is going to be able to look at those finances and realize the cost?
That's true. You'd think these days where we can like find out anything online, you know, that we'd be able to do.
Yeah,
some research on that. But
gentlemen, think
maybe
it
you
through.
Just don't want to know.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Think it through. All right, Jane, have a great weekend.
Thanks, you too.
It shouldn't matter.